Hey, it's SGU, and welcome back to the Joe Broadway Road to the Show series here in MLB The Show 17 on the PS4. Now, we are jumping back into the Yankees clubhouse here, checking out who we've got on the schedule today. It's the Seattle Mariners coming to Yankee Stadium. So let's throw it on out to the ballpark here, see what kind of day we're dealing with here. Going to be a beautiful one for baseball. I sure hope so. Show me. Yankee Stadium. Yep, looks good. Partly cloudy. We have the 68-47 record coming in. However, it's not even close to leading the division. I think we're five behind the Red Sox right now. Although we are firmly in first place wildcard position. As you see, Broadway's numbers to date, quite impressive. As he has already reached that 50 home run milestone for the season. They're down 1-0 in the first inning. Well, they were down 1-0 in the first inning. That is deep. And it is gone to left field. It lands in the half-full bleachers, which, again, I don't know why. We are playing very good baseball here, and you got a slugger that is just killing it, and that's all you can do in the stands? Come on, New York Yankees fans. Anyway, there's my near every episode rant about the fan base here and why the game glitches like that doesn't give us more fans. When this team, I realize they're not in first place, but I mean, they're playing well enough to be. They're just in the best division in baseball right now. Anyway, Broadway bomb number 51 on the season, and it carried quite a ways to left center field, as you see it land way back there. Give him 421 feet for number 51. So he's standing in once again, already 1-for-1. Let's see, hopefully we have the lead at this point. Yep, still up 2-1 with that two-run homer. Third inning's going to bring a shot to center field, and that one's staying in the ballpark. Tracked down and caught in center field. So Broadway's 1-for-2 now, and we got a 2-2 game in the fifth. Fielding at third, he got a drag bunt. He's going to come in, run, barehanded, throw to first, and get the out. Nice alert play by Broadway at third base, expecting the bunt, charging in and taking care of business. Let's take another look at it from Broadway's perspective, or at least from behind, as he's charging up here. Knows he should barehand this thing, and flings it on over to first, in time to get the runner. So let's check on him at the plate again, 1-for-2, with that two-run homer. He's pretty much everything for the Yankees offense so far. As a matter of fact, he is. But they could use some more since we're tied 2-2. This one is going to be chopped to second base. And what is going on there? What did the second baseman just do? He fielded the ball. Then he held it. Then he held it some more. Then he held it some more. And he finally throws it to first base. I mean, is the first baseman not covering? We don't see that in the play here. But he's got to be there, right? He's got nothing else to do. That's just a really perplexing play right there. They do not get a run out of that situation. Is it still 2-2? And oh, look at that. The off-speed breaking pitch there fools him, and it's strike three swinging. However, the Yankees go on to win, apparently, because we're being named as the player of the game with that two-run homer. And apparently the Yankees won it. Let's check the final score here. It is 4-3. So the Yankees get this first game against Seattle. And Joe gets Broadway bomb number 51 in the process in his very first at-bat there. You see, that's definitely the highlight of his day.
A hitter on a hot streak receives kudos from his batting coach.
Once again, making the hitting coach look good here. Having a perennial all-star and MVP candidate like Joe Broadway in your clubhouse. Hitting Broadway bombs left and right to the tune of 51 so far this season. And we are just in the month of August. You got half of August left and all of September, maybe a couple days into October for the regular season to play out and for him to make a run at Barry Bonds' record of 73 for a single season. So we are now on to Baltimore. After winning 2 of 3 against Seattle at home, we take our show on the road, stay within the AL East here, and Broadway hit another home run there while we were simming because he's now got 52 as he steps into the plate at Camden Yards. Let's go. This pitch is put in the air. It is out to center field, but it is not going to leave the ballpark. Gave it a ride, but Jones is there to make the catch. So it's 1-0 Yankees. You got a runner on third base and a chance for an R1 fielding opportunity. Backhand here. He does backhand it on the hop. Little bit of hesitation. The throw is not going to be in time. The run scores. and we're all tied at one apiece. The Orioles score a run without the ball, leaving the infield right there. And now we got the bases loaded, and at least there's two outs now. Throw over to first base this time will be in plenty of time, and the Orioles won't get anything further, but it is a 1-1 game. Broadway coming up already 0-1, looking for some results with the bat. He is looking for this first pitch. Maybe put it in play if he likes it, and oh, he likes it. Oh, wow. See you later. This one was absolutely crushed. The first one we saw was 421 feet at Yankee Stadium. I'm sure this one went farther. It went like down the tunnel there, out in left field. I want to see the measurements on this because Joe Broadway has definitely hit a Broadway bomb this time around. 53 on the year, 464 feet. We're going to see the show track on all this and get all the newfangled stats. Exit velocity, 112.2. Launch angle, 25. What else they got for us here? Going to get distance, I would imagine. Hang time is 6 seconds, just over 6 seconds, and 464 feet. It was absolutely crushed by Joe Broadway, and he's got 53 on the season. Now the Yankees have a 2-1 lead, and a nice patient eye right there. That one just off the corner of the plate, and it's ball four. Works a long at bat and a walk. We remain at 2-1. And Baltimore trying to tie this up. We've got another chance for a backhanded play. He's going to dive on this one. Gets to his feet. Throws quickly, low, but caught by the first baseman. And he's out. Nice play by Joe at third base. So we now have a 3-2 Yankees lead. And another at bat for Joe. We've got a runner on first base. He's going to ground that one up the middle. Nice play by the shortstop. Throwing and getting him. So no hit right there. He is retired, and the Orioles trying to come back, but Joe's going to get another at bat in this one. He's 1-for-3, and maybe looking to make it 2-for-4. Nope, not going to have a chance here. They got the infield in, but they're also going to walk him to put a force at any base. So Joe Broadway intentionally walked and will remain at 1-for-3 for this point. Well, that doesn't work out for the Orioles because it's now 6-2, and, well, that one's down the right field line. Broadway scores. Runner behind him is about to score, and it's now 8-2. So they absolutely tear this game open and look to be on their way to claiming game one of this series. Big clutch hit right here. Now they already had given themselves some insurance, but this one really seals the deal for the Yankees, who will indeed win the game. We'll see our final score in just a second here. It is a 8-2 final as they score quite a few runs from the seventh inning on and claim the victory. So a home run, a walk, and then an intentional walk for Joe in this game. Only one hit to his credit, but he was on base three times. So we win the second game in the Baltimore series, lose the last one. So that's two series in a row now. We've won 2 of 3, but it's on to Minnesota now and to Target Field, a place I'm very familiar with and spend a lot of time watching baseball here in my hometown, Twin Cities, Minneapolis, St. Paul. Joe Broadway coming up to hit here, and I would like to think I'd be in the stands if Joe Broadway came to town. Don't know if I'd be cheering him on with the Yankees, but that's another story. This is going to be a base hit, and he's going to take an extra base with the throw to third not being cut off. So you got runners in scoring position now and some trouble going. The Yankees 5-2, and it's only the second inning, and that one's ripped past the third baseman. Down the line, it's going to be another single. Yankees brought their bats today. So speaking of Yankees-Twins at Target Field, this series actually happens for real starting tonight. Three-game set with the Yankees in town. I'm thinking of going to that Thursday afternoon game. It's not the game Bartolo Colon is pitching for the Twins. That's going to be quite the circus on Tuesday night. But I think I will try to catch Aaron Judge and company in person on Wednesday afternoon. That's my plan right now. Yankees winning 5-2 at this point, and we really are not very far into the game. Just the fourth inning now. Twins have a runner on first. Broadway backhands that. He's going to throw quickly to second base, and they just do cut down the runner at second, the lead runner. They cannot turn two, however, but that is a nice play at third once again. We remain at 5-2. Top of the sixth inning. Joe puts a good swing on this, but it's going to hang up just long enough for the right fielder to make the catch. So he's now 2-for-4 with those two singles. Let's see, stepping into the box, if we can make this a three-hit game here at Target Field. It's 7-2 and the bases are loaded. He works a 2-0 hitter's count, and he puts it in the air to right. It is deep, it is back, headed towards the overhang, and gone. It is a grand slam Broadway bomb. Now, I've been known to go on and StubHub and get the first row seats in that overhang once in a while. I don't think this landed first row. Might have been a couple rows behind that, maybe even out towards the plaza, but I might have scurried for that one if I were in attendance. Of course, this year I've been sitting in the premium seating in catch out in center field when the prices are affordable on StubHub. I'm telling you, you can't beat the all-you-can-eat and drink out there and have the interactive screens and all that. Anyway, I guess my point of my story was if you have a chance to visit Target Field and you can snag the first row of that overhang, it's a nice experience. You should check it out sometime. Twins coming back. It's 11-8 in the ninth and strike three. No home run that time for Broadway. Have to settle for that grand slam he got, and hopefully we can hang on. It's 11-9. Make it 11-10. Oh, boy. This is not good. Do not let them come back. Okay, we finish it off in a nail-biter and a barn burner, 11-10. Two ninth-inning runs there by the Twins were not enough. We close it out. So a single, another single, and then later on a home run, a three-hit day for Joe Broadway. We checked the standings, and, well, we haven't made a whole lot of headway. We've won 7 of our last 10, but we are still 4 games out of the division lead and the Boston Red Sox. So let's get back to it here against the Twins. Game number 2, they are 48-72. Not a good season for the Twins. Luckily, we're not suffering through that bad of a season in real life, as they're just 2 games out of first place Cleveland. It's quite nice after the pitiful, pitiful season they had last year, and really just overall since Target Field opened. You had the one playoff series against the Yankees in 2010, the year it opened. But other than that, it's been quite miserable for Twins fans as far as competitive baseball. Now, it's just nice to see them playing for something at this point of the year after the All-Star break. And Twins are up 8-0 in this one right here. That's a ground ball to short, and the throw, not a good one. Can't be picked by the first baseman. So Joe will reach, and they're going to give him a hit. I'm a little surprised right there. They give him a hit. So now the batter's in the spot where he's got a 3-1 count. You don't expect they're going to pitch out and walk him. So we're going to try to take off. And this is a stolen base for Joe. Don't see a lot of them, but he picks his spots here and there. And this is one of those spots. So he's in scoring position. 3-2 count to the batter. And here's the pitch. Is hit to the gap deep and gone into the bullpens. Well, they'll get 2 runs back and get on the board. Former Twin Oswaldo Arcia is the one to take a deep. So maybe we can mount a comeback here tonight. We spotted him 8 runs, which is never good, but Arcia hits his 14th of the season, and maybe that will start some momentum the Yankees' way. We check out a replay as it's just out over the plate. He goes down and gets it, and he hits it a long way into the gap into the bullpens. So it's very interesting this year how Target Field has become a launching pad of sorts for home runs. It went from being one of the hardest ballparks to hit home runs in its first several years, and now it's starting to warm up. There was a theory going around that the concrete needed to settle, and once it did, the ball would start flying out, and we thought that was kind of preposterous when they mentioned that around here, but, I mean, how else do you explain the transition in this ballpark, and now all of a sudden being a home run hitter's park? Tried to stretch that to a double right there. Well, he's thrown out, and that's the kind of day it's been. We're down 8-2. Take it back on out to our third base position, and again, this one's going to be hit down the line. Quick reactions, hopefully slow motion, diving, making the play, getting up, throwing. Good strong throw is going to get his man at first. So another quick reaction play for Joe Broadway at third base. Let's see it again. Diving and trapping that thing, getting up as fast as he can, and delivering a on-target throw. Good stuff by number 22. So he takes to the batter's box again, 2-for-3 with those 2 singles, looking for another 3-hit game, possibly another home run. Hey, look at this. It's 8-5 right now. Ball is hit in the air. Center field. High, deep, but not nearly deep enough. It's caught over in right center, and he's out. So Broadway trying to get his team back into it, but couldn't do it there. He gets another opportunity. What's the score now? 2-for-4. And he's got another chance. It is an 8-6 game, and there's a runner on. Oh, man. Don't give him a chance to tie it here up the middle, and it's going to hit the second base bag. It stays in the infield. Well, I don't know that it would have made any difference if we would have taken any extra bases on that, but kind of a peculiar play, the ball hitting the bag. Yankees apparently do not tie it up as the Twins get the victory. Again, a game in the series getting a little too close for comfort with the team holding the big lead and watching it disappear, but they do win it 9-6. They put a run on in the bottom of the eighth to make it a little bit more breathing room, but there you go, three singles for Broadway in a losing effort. We got one more game in the series, but first we check out the career stats, including 316 homers now, as he and Matt Meyer are having quite parallel careers to this point with the home runs going on, both in the 300 club as they continue their careers. So out to Target Field for one more game in this series. Looks like a beautiful day. Let's get it going. 54 home runs. Man, he could reach 55 today with a big cut into the seats. Let's see if he can deliver the Broadway bomb and knock him out early. First inning, runner on, and well, that one's hit well. It's not going to leave the yard, but it's off the fence in right center. He's got a double. Runner's going to try to score. Relay throw, not in time, and that's an RBI double for Joe Broadway. Good piece of hitting here, and I still really like in MLB The Show 17 the new paths on hits. This one normally would just be on a straight line out there, but it just kind of slices to right center and ensures that he's going to get a hit. I just like the new pass that the ball takes off the bat this year. This one hit to right, but it's going to be caught, so Broadway will not score on the play as the inning ends. 1-0 Yankees. Bottom of the first now, and that one's hit right at him, and they say he caught it. No need to throw over to first base as he stabs the liner. Okay, Twins have tied it up. It's 1-1. Top of the third inning. Broadway going to cut and hit one to left field. Solid single. All of a sudden, this dude's got two hits again as he's coming through for the Yankees, and now he's got plenty of hits here as he's getting close to and approaching the 200 mark for hits in a season. This is popped up behind first base. If he can get himself settled, this should be an easy catch, and it is. So it's not going to get his third hit of the game, at least not in that at-bat. Let's take it further action here. 2-for-3, double, single, and RBI. Can he make it 3-4-4? It's a 1-1 game in the eighth inning. It'd be a big spot to drive a baseball out of here. That's high. I don't think it's particularly deep. And as a matter of fact, it's shallow center field, and it's caught. So Broadway out again. Who will get the run down the stretch to win this game? It's the Twins, and they take the series 2-1 with a victory. Not sure what the final score was here, but obviously they are able to get ahead and stay ahead and finish this one off. The small crowd celebrating a win, and it's a 3-1 victory as they score two in the bottom of the eighth, and that is plenty to get the victory. So a double and a single, and 2-for-4 for Broadway. So that's going to be the last of the on-field game action for this episode. Quite a lengthy episode this time around. Included as much as I could. When we come back, we got a series against Texas and beyond, and we are 4.5 games out. Like I said, solidly in the first place wild card spot. But what we really want is the AL East crown. Can we get it? Come on back next time as we try to start making our push down the home stretch. We will see you then.